In this video, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and set up your gameplay scene inside of Streamlabs with adding your gameplay, your webcam, and all your overlays to make that scene look professional. So on Streamlabs desktop, here on the left-hand side under scenes, you're going to hit this little plus icon, and we're going to go ahead and create a gameplay scene. So you will go ahead and label this gameplay. We'll go ahead and press done. And then once that go ahead and gets created, we're going to go ahead and select sources for gameplay. And this is where we're going to want to add in our overlays. Now, for this example, I'm going to utilize overlays from streamdesigns.com, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. They have tons of animated overlays you can go ahead and choose from. And for this example, I'm utilizing the Pixel World overlay, which you can see here is going to give us everything that we need to make our stream look professional with our overlay bar, our go ahead and our webcam overlay, and all our panels and screens that we need. And this is going to be an animated package that's going to go ahead and bring everything that we need to make the stream look professional. So once you go ahead and have your overlays, we'll come back here to Streamlabs and we'll click this little plus icon here. If you're using animated overlays, you'll select media file. If you're using static overlays, you'll select image. So because these are animated, I'm going to select media file, add source, and then we're going to go ahead and select add a new source instead. We'll name this overlay webcam. Add source, and now it's going to ask us to locate that file. So we'll hit browse, and then you want to go to where you downloaded your overlays from Stream Designs. It's going to come in a zip file just like this. If you're on Windows, you'll double click to be able to extract it. And if you're on Mac, you'll double click, and that's going to create a folder here for you. Once you have the folder, that's going to give you access to the overlays that you're going to need. So we'll see here our webcam overlay, and there's three different options. You have one that's just a border with nothing around it. You have one that has the border plus your donations, and another one that just has the bottom border if you want to utilize a green screen. So I'm going to utilize this one with the labels. Press open. We do want this to be able to loop, and then I'm going to go ahead and hit close. So now we have our webcam overlay. Now we need to go ahead and add our camera. So to be able to do that, you hit this little plus icon. We'll go ahead and select video capture device, add source. We're going to go ahead and add a new source, and we'll name this here camera for webcam overlay. Press add source. And now here you'll select your camera. Now, if you have gone ahead and added your camera to another scene, you can come to the plus icon, select video capture device, add source, and select that from an existing source. We have my camera here. We'll add that source, and I'll simply go ahead and drag this over the webcam overlay. Resize this, and then all I want to do is grab my camera and put it under my webcam overlay. And then we want to come to the right here and select create a folder. This is going to allow us to be able to group everything together. So once you click that there, it's going to give you a new folder. And all you want to do is grab your webcam overlay and just go over to the right. You'll see the folder open up. You'll come here over to the right and see the folder open up. And now we have this here. So now we can go ahead and resize this, and our camera stays in place and exactly where we want it to be. So let's say this is where I want my camera to be. So now I have that in place. So the next thing we want to go ahead and do is add in our gameplay. So to be able to do that, we're going to click this little plus icon. If you are gaming directly on your computer, then you're going to want to go ahead and do screen capture or window capture. So if you're game playing on your computer, you'll click window capture, add source. We'll name this game, add source there. And then you'll be able to go ahead and select your screen or your game that you want to be able to display. If you're utilizing a capture card, you're going to want to go ahead and select video capture device. So we'll come here, video capture device, add source, add new source. We're going to name this capture card, add source. And now we want to go ahead and select our capture card, which I have here. Here's my capture card. We'll select that there, and you can see here that this is going to be my gameplay. So now I'm going to make this as big as I possibly can. And then what I want to make sure is that my gameplay is under here, my camera. So now I have there, I have my gameplay, I have my webcam overlay. Now we want to go ahead and add our overlay bar so that we can show subscribers, followers, donations, all at the same time. So hit this little plus icon here. We're going to come to media file, add source. We're going to click add new source. We're going to name this overlay bar, click add source, and then we'll locate that file in our animated package that we got from Stream Designs. So we'll come back here to our package. We'll go to overlay screens, and you'll see here we have our overlay bar. So we'll click open. We do want this to be able to loop. Hit close. And now you see we have a new follower, new subscriber, new donation, and stream goal. So we're going to resize this to just be exactly where we want it to be. And we'll go ahead and place this right in the center here at the top. So now we have that in place. So we have our webcam, we have our overlays, we have our gameplay, and now we have our overlay bar here as well. But what you want to do now is you want to be able to go ahead and make sure that when somebody follows, their name pops up here. When somebody subscribes, their name pops up here, or donates, their stream goes, and same thing here for the bottom. So what I want you to do is watch this video right here where I show you how to go ahead and set up stream labels so that way those names pop up automatically. Click that video right there. See you in the next video.